Halloween, a tradition that has been celebrated for thousands of years, which in modern times is associated with scary costumes, pumpkin carving, and trick-or-treating. It has become one of the most commercialised festivities in the annual calendar. But why do people celebrate Halloween? And do they know where it originates? I'm Charlotte, an actor and writer living in London. I love meeting new people and exploring the way in which others live their lives. I want to find out the traditions of Halloween and the real history behind the festival of ghosts, witches, and all things spooky. Throughout my journey, I will meet with experts about its pagan origins. I will explore paganism in the 21st century, learn about modern-day witches, and even give it all a try for myself. I'm here at Greenwich Market to find out what people think about Halloween and where it comes from. Let's see what spooktacular things they've got going on. Do you know the origins of Halloween?
I haven't a clue, but I'm guessing it probably has something to do with Salem, Massachusetts, by any chance.
I thought it was a pagan ritual, like every so often people get together and celebrate the undead.
It's just an excuse, at least now, to get dressed up, typically for scaring people.
Mean anything? No, I think it's just the ritz and glitz. You get to dress up and have fun.
It's clear from Greenwich Market that Halloween is just an excuse for us to dress up and an opportunity for retailers to earn money. It's evident that not many of us know the true origins of Halloween or how it began. Halloween began in Ireland centuries before Christ, when tribal warriors called the Celts lived throughout the British Isles on the shores of the Irish Sea. The most important night for them being the last day of the harvest and the first day of the dark of winter. On that night, the Celts believed that the boundary between the world of the living and the spirit world was unusually thin, so thin that the souls of the dead would roam free. That night was important to the Celts. They called it Samhain. On Samhain night only, the Celts believed that those who died from the past year could roam the earth once more. To calm these spirits, the Celts would parade out to the edge of their villages with offerings to coax the evil spirits away from their homes, leaving food and sweets outside as gifts for the dead, a tradition that eventually became trick-or-treating. I was excited to explore its traditions more at my first pagan festival. I'm in South London, where I'm about to attend a traditional pagan celebration of Samhain. I'm excited to learn more about paganism and to experience what really happens in the world of witchcraft.
If I can't have the girl I love, I won't have none at all. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove I know.
After searching through the stalls and learning about crystals and tarot readings, I asked some of the interesting individuals that I met what they felt the meaning of Samhain is.
The 1st of November is literally the first of a brand new year. So, on Samhain, if you burn up all the stuff that you don't want, you then start the new year with a clean slate. And of course, a bottle of mead.
Wicca is an infusion of things like spell work, working with the god and goddess, working with earth energies. So it tends to be a little bit of everything under the umbrella of paganism. So they tend to follow a doctrine of doing a little bit of everything.
Then it was time for the real celebrations to begin.
Thank you. thank you to the Golden Goddess to be with us so far this day, and I'm sure they'll be with us for the rest of the night. And for all those blessings and all those smiles that we've seen today, may they continue. From the heart, blessed it be.
From the heart, blessed it be.
My first experience of paganism and Samhain, I was so surprised by how welcoming everybody was and how much they wanted to share their festival with me. I realised that you can make paganism whatever you want it to be, as long as it comes from the heart. From the heart, blessed be. I learnt a lot about the traditions of Halloween at the pagan festival. But in order to understand more about its origins, I wanted to dig deeper and discover the history of Wicca and witches. One of the most associated characters within Halloween is the witch. We identify them as women who wear pointy hats, own black cats, and ride a broomstick. But where do witches come from? Witch hunts were often started by superstitious villagers. In 1486, a guidebook for correctly finding witches was published. And within this book, it stated that a sure sign of a witch was a devil's mark on the body. Another method was the process of swimming a witch. The theory was that water being pure would reject all evil. The belief was that a witch would float and an innocent person would sink. And if a person was found to be a witch, they would be persecuted. The most common form of persecution was being burnt at the stake, a form of torture commonly associated with Joan of Arc. It seems that the common assumption of witches being predominantly women comes from the Salem witch trials. As in Salem during the 1600s, Puritan women were expected to be silent and submissive to their husbands. Due to her lustful nature, a woman would be more likely to desire sexual relations with the devil. Many have associated witches with sorcery and satanic possession, but most witches today are not at all like their negative stereotypes. I went to visit Treadwell's, an occult bookshop dedicated to the esoteric magical world, to meet with its owner, practicing witch, Christina, to find out more about the spirituality of Wicca.
We do, when we do magic, in a sense, it's a bit like I don't know, Christians when they're praying, in the sense that it's about healing and balance and inner and centeredness. But when we get those portrayals out there, I think we just, at least I do, I try to have an understanding of what being a witch is, that if you're a bit different, you are going to be portrayed as a little bit threatening, traditionally anyway, and you kind of have to embrace that dangerousness a little bit.
I like that. Seeing as we're in your fabulous bookshop, mm-hmm. I was wondering if you could show us some tools or some exciting
things. It's and pieces. Well, I've talked about herbs. We've got magic. We've got the essential oils. These come straight from the plants. We've got candles. But in terms of tools, you know, it can be very, very complex. Some people love their stuff, love their kit, and other people just have got a stick from a tree.
In order to learn more about how Halloween is still celebrated traditionally today, I met with practicing pagan and Wiccan high priest, Manny.
We'd create the magic circle, consecrating people with incense and salt water, or purification, things like that. And that's just to kind of stop anything outside coming in, and to kind of stop any energies that we are raising inside leaking out. And then what happens is that you invoke the Dark Lord. What that person is doing as the Dark Lord is opening up a magical boundary between this world and the world of the dead. I was talking about wearing masks in rituals to kind of semi-hide the person who is doing a particular role. This thing is a really important symbol. Everybody would recognize that it's a pentagram. When you've done various magical work and you're kind of slightly out of it, for example, you know, you've done a ritual and you're kind of feeling woozy, or then what happens is that you ground yourself. You know, it's literally bang on the ground. It's bringing you, that phrase, down to earth. Finally, it's just chords. You know, you can get that anywhere. It's also got a magical purpose. You tie a little knot, but you do it loosely like that. Then you do a little chant or like a small phrase, or it could be anything, and you just kind of tie it.
It's Halloween night, and after learning so much about the traditions of Halloween, or Samhain, I feel ready to attend my first ritual. I'm going to the River Thames to take part in the River of Souls ceremony ritual as a celebration of Samhain and to honour the spirit of the Wiccan's ancestors.
Everybody, take hands with the person beside them. The world flows about us, and we are safe on the banks of the Thames.
Let us be at one with the power, the power that rules the universe.
Mighty ones of the West, spirits of water, we call on you to wash away our fears and griefs and cleanse us as we bid to you. Hail and welcome.
Hail and welcome.
Hecate, Keridwen, dark mother, take us in. Hecate, Keridwen, let us be reborn. Hecate, Keridwen, dark mother, take us in. Hecate, let us be
overall, after learning so much from this experience, what I have discovered the most from all the wonderful, welcoming people I've met is that the taboo idea of witches and Halloween is not actually that creepy like most would expect. But it's truly very positive and uplifting. And I think it's lovely that some do still celebrate Halloween as it was intended to be celebrated all those thousands of years ago.
And his son. The scene was rocky, all were digging the sounds. Igor on chains, backed by his baying hounds. The coffin bangers were about to arrive with their vocal group, the Crypt Kicker Five.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They played the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash. Out from his coffin, Jack's voice did ring. Seemed he was troubled by just one thing. Opened the lid and shook his fist and said, whatever happened to my Transylvania twist?
It's now the mash.